Eric Keller here, Enthusiast Auto Group. Welcome back to EAG's HQ yet again for another first look opportunity before this very special car hits the website. It may look a little bit familiar, having been flashed as a very early first look in one of our earlier videos. This is a 2003 Dinan Stage 2 M5, Sterling Grey over Black Sport, Titan trim, full options. Been out in the Southwest its whole life, started life in Vegas, and was used primarily in that region, heading between there and, Southern California. Father, son, the son reached out to us here recently, and through a great client contact, they dropped us a line and said, hey, let's keep this in a great home before it goes mainstream, and that's exactly what we did. This car has, all the right things going for it. It's a very late production. The VIN actually ends in 993 for any Porsche enthusiasts out there. This car certainly will keep up with the best of them in this S2 trim. The car has 51,000 and change miles. Let's take a closer look there. 51,629. It is in remarkably good shape for this age and this mileage. You don't see them preserve this well, but when it is coming from an original owner stable, this is not too big of a surprise for us. It is much better than what we'll typically find in the normal open market. And that's what we start with, starting with a car that has bones and DNA and history and a loving, caring, enthusiast ownership. History is exactly what we are known for. And then, $10,000, $12,000, $15,000 later of investment into the car's future, it doesn't need that much. We are consciously choosing to invest that much so the next owner doesn't have to, and that provides them with a really, really great, low-cost, low-stress, maximum fun ownership experience that we've become well-known for. Quick little intro sidebar, I guess, playing right off of that. This car is a great example of that. This is another first look. You'll notice a California license plate there in the reflection. EAG bought this car from the first owner, too. This was a long time ago, though, like 2010 or so, maybe even longer than that. It'll be in the data file if you're interested. And we sold it to an owner in California. He owned the car from 27,000 miles to about 60,000 miles. We bought the car back, put it through the program again, found another enthusiast, actually even sold it before we could even get the car really processed on the website. Bought the car back at 65,000 miles. Same thing happened again before we could even get photos in the studio. The car sold it came back just last year. Now at 74,000 miles, this 2003 M5. Again, all records, all history back to the original owner, just as we've started our relationship with this very special M5, is on file, and that's going to be included to the next owner with a car that you can drive and use and enjoy. This car is, it's still fantastic shape. It was traded in on another EAG BMW, and it's been out west a good portion of its life, and having all of that data to rely on is part of what comes with buying an EAG car. We're going to be more expensive, yes, but you're going to get what you pay for. The S2 trim package on these M5s is, frankly, in my opinion, the absolute best setup. The Stage 3 is nice, and it's cool and fun, but it's too much car. It's too go fast. You can't quite use all that power all the time, and that's what the E39s are really best known for, is you can use all that power all the time. And it's a car that you can absolutely have a ball with and feel like you're in total control of. You're going to notice we've got quite a bit of extras that come with the car, both the California and the Nevada plates. We've got the Dinan still new floor mats. We've got a good history file, including the Stage 2 receipts in there. I'm not going to flash all the owner information, but about $40,000. I think in this case it was $37,000 of goodies for that Stage 2 package. The original window sticker here showing $75,345. Five options are available on a sport interior car. We've got folding rear seats, we've got the M audio, we've got the rear lip spoiler, the sunshades, and of course these lovely handy dandy park sensors. Having all of this stuff is certainly great and important and part of what comes with most of the EAG cars. We don't always get the window stickers, but when we do, and all that extra stuff, we pass it forward after scanning it into our system, so we can certainly retrieve that for future owners just in the event something happens. But going back to the performance level of the S2s, I mean, they really, really just, it's the ultimate form of the E39. You know, the S1 or S1 Plus, as we built, you know, a couple, I don't know, six, seven dozen of, maybe more over the years. You know, that definitely, and a lot of you guys watching probably have one of those cars from us at this point. And that, you know, that is absolutely the best package for the money. You know, 10, 15, 20 grand at most with a diff. Get you much, much closer to the S2 level for, well, half the money. That extra, you know, 20 grand, though, gets you the throttle bodies, gets you the headers, gets you the velocity stacks, the stage 4, in this case, stage 5 software. It becomes a bit of a beast, and I would love to take you for a ride, go out and drive and do what I would love to do with this car right at the moment. However, that's going to have to be for a different video, time permitting. The interesting thing about this car to me that's even more standout than the history and storyline I've shared with you at this point is the ownership profile for perfection. The previous owner was just not one to have any type of imperfections or blemishes, hence why I've really not been able to showcase really any stone chips or any, you know, obvious blemishes here in my walk around on the car. And that's because if there was a blemish anywhere on the car, it obviously was corrected, because you're going to, well, I'm going to do this really close and slow here for the next 30, 40 seconds. And there isn't much to share with you. I did know this coming in, but the car has had, you know, some paint work here and there. The front bumper, that just wipes off. The car did paint meter out thoroughly and in a comprehensive manner before we agreed to move forward with the purchase. And the hood and the fenders and the front bumper and the roof and the two front doors and the top, just the top of the trunk lid, have been painted, whereas the rear with the VIN tag of the trunk has not been painted. I'm guessing the tape line was put there. The quarter panels have not been painted. If there were blemishes, these things were taken care of, because those just were not acceptable, is I guess the right word. And overall, I would say the paint and the quality is very, very good. There are two small issues that we're going to be taking care of, part of the rejuve roadmap. I'll go into those more specifically with any interested parties, but rest assured, the finished quality product is going to be exactly what we're known for, and the car's condition is, well, it's going to be on point with the pricing, something we'll be happy to share with anybody that's interested in becoming the next custodian and owner. We paid up for this car, paid quite a bit more than I normally would pay for a car with this type of mileage, even as an S2, but you know, they're not making any more of them, especially in the final model year, in this color combo with one owner history in the, you know, Southwest. That just, you know, it's kind of got a lot of dream stats going for it, and I'm sure that there's no shortage of people salivating at the moment here in just you know, the early stages. The rejuve process has just only begun. With just a couple things done at the moment, we've put our refinished wheels and fresh tires on, a couple small interior bits, but paint correction, all that type of stuff, the big heavy-duty mechanical lifting has not yet been done, because frankly, we've been working on sold cars nonstop, like the Z4M Coupe you see there in the background. Congratulations to the new owner up in Michigan. You are a, an awesome guy to work with. I've really gotten to know you over the last month or so, especially when you decided to make a two-for-one deal, adding in another EAG BMW with this 2007 Z4M Coupe that has a whopping 5,000 miles on it. Apologies for the cleanliness. It is not yet fully cleaned up and detailed. We've been driving the car. We've been installing your requested upgrades and updates, like the ZCP or CSL wheels and the intake. And we got some exhaust on there as well. This thing is certainly going to complement your other BMWs well, and looking forward to rejuvenating those two cars for you too. So really kind of hit it out of the park right out the gates, didn't we? So sold you two cars and you're sending two more down to for rejuve once these cars arrive. So you know, super thankful for relationships like that. Even that's a you know, first time client, whereas a lot of these owners we've sold this M5 to have not been first time clients. And we can, you know, with confidence put our best clients that want a driver and something they can use and enjoy in a car like that, because we've got really great confidence in that car, like this Lemans Blue on, I believe, Fox Red. This is a recent arrival to the EAG program, only to return back because, again, I'm going to have to defer to Evan a bit more, and apologies for the cleanliness. It's not super cleaned up at the moment. Heading up to photo prep soon. That's a 2010 model that has about 50,000 miles that EAG originally acquired from the first owner and put a multiple repeat family in that car. We don't make many exceptions to the rules, but when we do, we got to make sure we've got all the right ducks in a row, and that car didn't disappoint. And then a bit of a teaser, we have another collection that we've acquired, and you're going to see a really cool video coming soon that has me out there hot dogging it, and I'll just say it's the first M car ever built, and that's another fun one I can't wait to put together. Just a quickie. It's nothing going to be super fancy, but there's going to be some great engine noises that come with that video. And this car's stablemates, really great collection out of Northern California, quite a well-known and prominent enthusiast to the mark. And you better subscribe for more, because it's going to be a wild ride over the next coming weeks. We got some serious stuff that's EAG firsts, many of. I've never been able to put a camera where I've put this one, and made some really fun footage for you to share. So thanks again for tuning in and subscribing and the support. This is going to be, again, just a quick down and dirty one take, as you can tell I'm fighting the camera here. But I do appreciate everybody tuning in. The white E30 M3 we did this late night video on just a week ago has been spoken for with another repeat client heading down to Florida. So a lot more cool stuff coming in. The videos certainly are a great way to introduce you to these cars before they hit the website and other major media outlets. And so do subscribe for more of these updates, and appreciate everybody tuning in. Thanks again. See ya.